Hi everybody, it's Nancy here, your health coach. Welcome to this afternoon's health coaching session. Today we're going to be talking about gluten. So gluten now, like most of the modern wheat has three times the amount of gluten as like even just 20 years ago. That's why a lot of people are reacting so easily to gluten, because there's three times the amount in our foods in modern wheat. And what's happening is that it's really causing a lot of inflammation, mostly in the gut. And what's happening is that it's affecting the cortisol. It's releasing cortisol and zonulin, which is like the stress response, to help buffer that inflammation. And it's just causing you to feel more anxious, and it's causing mood disorders, and it's causing, it affects your thyroid, and it causes potential leaky gut syndrome. So you have to really consider alternatives when it comes to gluten. You don't have to have a gluten sensitivity or celiac to make healthier choices when it comes to crowding out gluten with healthier options. Because if you've noticed, like if you take a moment and you're in a good mood, and then say you have gluten, and then you notice your mood shifting right away, that should be gluten's got to go. Like just in those little symptoms, just tells you how much gluten is not good for us. It doesn't belong in our body. It affects our mood, our brain, our like energy. It's been found that it affects the ADD, ADHD, autism. It also affects, what else does it affect here? Our skin. It can create diverticulitis. It affects anxiety and depression. So really, I mean, there's so many options out there that you can like substitute gluten with. And they made it so like available for us to crowd it out with something that's healthier. So if you're looking at in a form of a tortilla, like a wrap, you can use either like a lettuce leaf, which, you know, we all need more green leafy greens in our diets. It has high amounts of chlorophyll, which is a great detoxifier, which helps eliminate all the excess toxins from our food, from our environment, from radiation. All that really helps to increase your green leafy greens and vegetables. So you can use leafy greens, you can use coconut wrap, you can use cassava, which is a root vegetable that is found in, you can buy it in the form of a wrap. It's a flower, which is the root vegetable. It helps to feed the good bacteria inside your gut. So my number one go-to is cassava flour. I make these little small crepes. You can either use it as a savory or a sugar, like a sweet or savory, either one works. It's a very easy to do. It's a cup of cassava flour and a quarter cup of a dairy-free milk, one egg, cinnamon, a little bit of lemon juice, and vanilla extract. You mix that all together, and you just heat up your pan with coconut oil, and then you just make these nice soft skinny tortillas or crepes, and then you can use them as a regular wrap. You can do that, or you can buy them. There's also California cauliflower wraps that you can use, brown rice wrap. There's so many options out there that it's really great to see, but you also have to be careful, because it is a business where a lot of the companies are taking advantage of the gluten-free community. So yes, they can say it's gluten-free, but it could be linked with all kinds of different fillers and preservatives. So you want to make sure to read the labels when it comes to crowding out with gluten with other options. A lot of the times though, if you read the ingredients, it'll just say either cassava flour or chickpea flour or lentil flours, or black beans, or brown rice flour, quinoa. Like, I mean, there's so many options, but just make sure to read the labels if you're going to buy it. Hi, Lori. Thank you so much for joining me. So yeah, we're talking about gluten, and not necessarily, you don't have to be sensitive to gluten or have celiac disease to crowd out gluten with healthier options, because you will notice that it can easily affect your mood, it can easily affect your energy, it can easily affect your attention span, and I think because it's three times the amount of gluten that we have in modern wheat, as opposed to even just 20 years ago, where we didn't have that much of a a negative response to whole wheat. Because whole grains in itself is beneficial. I mean, we whole grains such as spelt or kamut or and like just whole grains in itself has many healthy properties. It has phytonutrients, which helps with just fight against diseases. It has fiber. It has good amounts of healthy fats and carbs. So I mean, you have to make sure that it's quality organic whole grains and none of that refined whole wheat and white bread or anything like that. So just make sure to crowd out with healthier options, especially if you're finding yourself like reacting easily to gluten. Like, you don't necessarily have to have a sensitivity to gluten to go gluten-free. It's actually healthier for you if you go gluten-free. And with today, there's so many options. You know, you can get cauliflower crust, you can get brown rice crust or tortilla wraps, or even like noodles. You can get like kelp noodles, brown rice noodles, zucchini noodles, chickpea noodles. I mean, there's just so many alternatives out there. And if you really want to go in more details, I do have in, I think it's module 3 of my online course, I really go into greater details of what to crowd out with healthier options. And in that portion in there, I talk about modern wheat and gluten and what to crowd out with for healthier options and for you to be healthier. And and yeah, you want to check it out. I'll post it in the comments section, the link to the online course. It's focused more on how to reduce your stress and enhance your vitality, because I'm living proof that I was able to manage my anxiety through nutrition and lifestyle and healthier habits and healthier options. And now I want to share with the world what I've learned and experienced, so that way that you don't have to go through what I went through. So just learn from other people's experience rather than suffering through your own. If you have any questions before I let you go, today is really just about focusing on gluten and substituting gluten with healthier options. And like I said, like, we use quinoa, which is a main staple in our home. We use quinoa instead of whole wheat. We use rice. Mind you, we do buy organic rice because it's been found that there is arsenic in just any type of rice. So if you go for organic rice, then you're good to go. And also there's ways of fermenting whole grains, so it's easier on your digestion. But the key is to really reduce the inflammation in your gut and in your body, because that's the silent killer of most diseases, like leaky gut syndrome, autoimmune diseases, diabetes, cancer, cardiovascular disease, all those things. So the key is to really learn how to reduce inflammation as much as possible, and that is including taking gluten out. So if you have any questions for me or comments, please feel free to let me know before I let you guys go. I just wanted to jump on real quick and just educate you on gluten and modern wheat and how it's really not good for us. It wreaks havoc on our gut and our system, and there's so many healthier ways that you can substitute gluten with. Quinoa, chickpea, coconut, cassava, which is my favorite because it's a root vegetable and it feeds the good bacteria, and it really is very similar to a whole wheat, so it's a really great way to cook, and not cook, but yeah, cook and bake with, so you can do that. Yeah, so I'll leave you guys with that. Have yourselves a great afternoon, and then we will talk to you guys tomorrow morning on our morning show at 7:15, where we share a little bit of insight, a little bit of humor, and it's just so much fun doing it, and I'm happy that you guys are able to join us every weekday morning at 7:15. Have yourselves a great day, and we'll talk to you guys later. Cheers.